Hey guys, welcome to HR with Sanchita. So today the topic that we'll study is balance scorecard in HRM. So balance scorecard has become really popular nowadays. So in today's lesson, we would understand balance scorecard and its different perspectives. And yes, feel free to like, share and subscribe to my channel because I'll keep on posting videos related to HRM, labor laws, UGC NET students here, right? So the balance scorecard has been given by David Norton and Robert Kaplan. So you need to remember this, that who has given the balance scorecard. It is often asked in competitive exams. Okay. So what is balance scorecard? Okay. So see, balance scorecard, what it does is it aligns business activities to the vision and strategy of the organization. Okay. So what does it align? All the business activities, all the activities in an organization are in line with the vision and strategy of the organization. And how does it see that the business activities are in alignment with the vision and strategy? By monitoring performance against strategic goals. So there are various strategic goals of an organization. So what it does, it monitors performance, okay, to see that whether we are carrying on activities according to our vision and strategies. So the traditional method of measuring the organizational performance just make use of external accounting data. So generally, earlier what we did, and most of the companies now also, which are not that much developed, what they are doing is they are just taking into account the accounting data, checking whether we are going into profits or whether we are going into losses, okay, how much liabilities we have. So what they are doing is they are just checking the accounting data, okay. They are not taking into account other perspectives, okay, which are very essential to achieve the vision and strategy of the organization. So why this balanced scorecard approach has come? So this balanced scorecard approach has come so that we just not rely on the accounting data itself, but we take other things into account as well, along with the financial perspective. So the approach is to provide balance to the financial perspectives. That means that we are not just taking the accounting data to see whether the organization and the processes are in line with the strategy. We are taking other data also. We are judging or analyzing other perspectives as well, along with the financial perspectives. So in this slide, we are being given the benefits of the balanced scorecard. So from the last discussion, you must have been aware that what can be the benefits of the balanced scorecard. So what it does is improves organizational performance. So this all is just generic. Obviously, it will improve the organizational performance, and we can focus on strategy and results, and whether we are working out according to the strategy or not, and align organizational strategy with workers on day-to-day basis. So if we are not working according to the strategy, by analyzing the different perspectives of the balanced scorecard, which I'll discuss further, right? So what we can do is we can align. If we are going on a different path, we can come on the path which is going along with our strategy, and improve communication of the organization's vision and strategy. So the vision and strategy should be known to all the people working in the organization. So if only top people know, or the workers working in the top level management know, okay, so then it would not be beneficial, because strategies are actually implemented and brought operational by the middle level management or the lower level management, okay. So that is why the strategy, vision and mission should be known to all the people working in the organization. Now let's see what are the four perspectives that are there in the balanced scorecard, which we analyze, right? So customer perspective, learning and growth perspective, internal process perspective, and it is also known as business process perspective in some books. So it is the same, internal process or business process, and the financial perspective. So see, in the balanced scorecard, we are analyzing three other perspectives along with the financial perspectives, right? So these all things are also important along with the accounting of financial data, right? So customer comes into the picture, which are really important for the organization. Learning and growth. So what is the learning and growth happening in the organization? Are we stagnant, or we are moving towards innovation, right? Because innovation is a really desired factor for the success of the organization nowadays. And internal processes. Now let's see further that what are there in these all perspectives. Now comes the customer perspective. So see, it is often told in marketing that customer is the kingpin in the market and every activity is done according to the customer, right? So whatever new products we are bringing into the market, that is to attract new customer, retain our existing customers and satisfying the customers, right? So here, so it can be analyzed, measured by the following parameter. So how we measure customer perspective. So see, we have got a dimension that this is customer perspective of the balance scorecard. Now what dimensions we need to see? So these are the dimensions that we need to see. That is the customer satisfaction. How satisfied are our customers? If our customers are not satisfied, then we are not going on track. Customer acquisition. Are we able to acquire new customers, right? Then what are the services that we are giving them? Are we giving them proper after sales service? Okay, then customer retention. So once we've acquired our customers, are we able to bring out repeat purchases from them, right? Then market share. What is the market share as compared to our competitors? So this is the customer perspective. So now comes the internal process perspective, okay, so which is also known as business process perspective in some books. So what all it includes is operations, okay, innovation, quality, costs. So what are the costs associated with our products, right? What is the quality, right? Are we giving good quality products? What are the operations, the business, different business processes that we are following to manufacture products, to distribute products, to store products, for the warehousing of our products or services, okay? So all these come into the account of operations. Then what are the innovations that we are doing, right? So this is internal process perspective. Now comes the learning and growth perspective. So all these things are included under this perspective. So employee retention, training, so growth, learning, you can understand that training would be coming into the picture. So are we able to retain our employees, right? Leadership, motivation, morale. So this is really important, right? All our OB terms, leadership, motivation. So the leadership should be really good. We should be able to motivate our employees and boost their morale, right? What is the employee turnover? So we should reduce employee turnover. Employee turnover is like the people that are leaving the organization, right? Yeah, so in terms of HR, turnover is not sales. Employee turnover is that the people who are leaving the organization. So the organization's goal should be to reduce the employee turnover, right? And job satisfaction, whether the employees are satisfied. So how can we satisfy employee? By giving good leadership, by motivating them, by boosting their morale. So this all is included in the learning and growth perspective. So now comes the financial perspective. So all these are included in the financial perspectives. You must be aware, cash flow, return on investment, the profits, right? What are the financial results of the enterprise? So everything related to the finance, our balance sheet, okay, our cash flow statement, our return on investments, right? If we are investing somewhere, are we getting proper and increased returns on it, right? What are our profits? Are they increasing, okay, or are they decreasing, or they are just stagnant, okay? So that is it. That is all included in the financial perspective. So there are many things included under these all perspectives. So I have put down a few, right? Okay. So this is over. And yes, feel free to like, share and subscribe my channel. Okay. And the link to my Telegram page I have provided and pinned in the comments. Okay. Take care.